Good morning, children. Today we are going to discuss about the chapter of biology, the chapter 9, diseases and first aid. Okay, and in this chapter, that many contents are there, but today we are going to discuss about this, the communicable diseases only. And the other learning objectives are vectors, then prevention of diseases, then vaccination and immunization, then first aid. But in this class, we are going to discuss about this communicable diseases. And you already learned that what's the meaning of disease and what are the two main kinds of diseases. So here, this communicable disease is related with this bird's disease. That means health and hygiene is connected with the disease. We know that what is the meaning of health. Health means the physical, mental and social well-being of an individual is called the health. And hygiene and health, these two words are related with each other. So, that health and hygiene have a direct relation with the diseases. And that means we need to maintain the good health and keeping our surroundings and clean. Keeping our surroundings clean, and that will help us to reduce the occurrence of diseases. So, let's start this about the diseases. And we know that disease means the disturbance of the meaning of disease is the disturbance in the normal functioning of the body. That means what are the disturbance in happening in our normal body functioning, that's called a diseases. And we know that every year millions of people are dying due to different kinds of diseases. So we have also experienced in the last year that coronavirus was affected to number of people in different parts of the world, and that is also coming into the category of a communicable disease. And here, and millions are suffering, millions of people are suffering due to different kinds of diseases. For example, cancer and other mild diseases. Mild diseases that is affecting in our daily life, you know. That means cold and fever is also coming into the category of communicable diseases. So let us start with the communicable disease. So we know that two types of diseases are there. And this is the one of the disease that means communicable disease. And another is the non-communicable disease. So here, on the basis of that communicability, diseases can be divided into two types. Communicable diseases and non-communicable diseases. And communicable diseases are caused due to different kinds of microorganisms. We know that what are the common microorganisms are there, such as bacteria, then fungi and viruses. But the non-communicable diseases, that is caused by the malfunctioning of organs. And here, and we know that in this chapter, the table 9.1 is mentioned there, that is the difference between communicable diseases and non-communicable diseases. There. And total five differences are mentioned there. Communicable disease means that is very harmful, and that is caused by microorganisms like that bacteria, virus are like that. But non-communicable disease, that is happening because of the malfunctioning or abnormal growth of body cells or malfunctioning of the organs. And this communicable diseases are transmitted. Transferring from an infected person to a healthy person. But that non-communicable diseases are not transferring from one person to another. And the examples are there. And you need to learn this table 9.1, what is mentioned in the book, that is in page number 134. Page number 134. One table is there. And this table is showing that the difference between communicable diseases and non-communicable disease with their examples. So that is the homework for today's class. And after that, communicable diseases that the National Institute of Communicable Diseases NICD, that is mentioned there. NICD means that the National Institute of Communicable Diseases is there, and that is situated in Delhi. And the aim of this institute is that developing the methods of control of various types of communicable diseases. And types of, next is, now we know that what's the difference between communicable disease and non-communicable disease, and what are the examples of that. And now the next topic is types of communicable disease. What are the types of communicable disease? And depending on that, how this disease is spreading, that communicable diseases are many types. And look at that, the one means that one is mentioned there, that's related with the air, that means airborne diseases. The diseases, that means the communicable diseases that spreading through the air. And so germs, we know that common cold, then influenza, measles, tuberculosis, these diseases are spreading through the air. So this is the first medium, that means air. So we are calling that airborne diseases. And the second one is waterborne disease. That means the diseases that are spreading through the water. For example, that contaminated water, that impure water, that the people are using different kinds of impure water, so that will cause the spread of this waterborne disease. And we should always drink the water which is free from the germs, otherwise this will affect that waterborne disease. So airborne diseases, waterborne diseases, and next one is the third is the foodborne disease. That foodborne disease is a contaminated food or unhealthy food or contaminated food that will cause the eating unclean food, vegetables, or consumption of rotten food or unhygienic food. So that will cause the foodborne disease. And the next is the direct contact. So that fourth one is direct contact. That means the person who are affecting that any kind of communicable disease, and the other healthy person is going to be contact with the infected person, then that will cause to the spread of that disease. For example, common cold, conjunctivitis. Conjunctivitis means redness of eyes. So that is also an example, that flu is there, then chicken pox is there. So these are spreading through the direct contact of an infected person. And the next one is through bodily fluid. Body fluid is the next medium of spreading. So some communicable diseases that is spreading through the exchange of body fluids. Generally, that means as a result of some contact with an infected person. For example, that AIDS is one of the deadly disease that is also spreading through this kind of body fluid. So the example is AIDS. Acute immune deficiency syndrome is that. So body, this is spreading through the bodily fluid, and that is also coming into the category of communicable disease. Then the last one is animal bites. Animal bites means the best example of that is rabies. Animal bites, this is spreading. That means diseases that are caused through the bite of an infected animal. An example is rabies. So this is the topic of today's class, and I'm going to revise this topic again. That means we already learned that what is the meaning of communicable disease, and you know that two types of diseases are there: communicable diseases and non-communicable diseases. Communicable disease means that is spreading from the infected person to a healthy person. And what are the different types of communicable disease? That means what are the ways this is communicating from one person to another. Through airborne diseases are there, and the next is waterborne disease, and the next is foodborne disease, then through the direct contact with an infected and the body fluid of an infected person and through the animal bites. So these are the topic, and the common book today's is page number 134. That one table is there, that table 9.1, that you should learn and write your book. Okay, thank you.